Hello and good evening. Yeah, so we are live. Hello and good evening. Welcome to the Electric Live Webinar, episode number 3. And I'm Sonika Solomon, your host for today. And before starting the webinar, I really want to say one thing to all of you. Thank you. You must be thinking that why I'm saying thank you. But if you can think about the things happening, it's been just 1 month we have completed Janta Curfew, and after 1 day, on 24th, we will be completing 1 month of our national lockdown. And it's really amazing to see all the people around me and the community for being such a responsible citizen. Thank you for being that. And we have given a perfect example in front of all that how we are dealing with this lockdown situation in this whole 1 month. And really, thank you for being one of them. Before starting the webinar, I like to just a minute. I'm just seeing all the screen is perfect or not. Okay. Hello. We have a few attendees over here. Hello. I welcome all the attendees over here, and thank you for coming. All of them who have joined us and given time and listening to us, thank you for coming. The people who have attended us before, thank you for coming again, joining us again and listening out us. And thank you who are joining us for the first time. Thank you for joining us. And this is our episode number 3. We have already done 1 and 2 webinar. You can check out our previous webinar episodes in YouTube. And we have recorded webinar also over there. And we have, but can see over there also. So we will be attaching our YouTube link and LinkedIn link in the chat box, and you can see over there. So so today's webinar is all about multi-channel success with marketing automation. So you must be aware of few of you are here in the webinar. Some can be a beginner in marketing automation. Some can be in professional. Having an experience, good amount of experience in the career of marketing and knowing about marketing automation. But how to use it, how to use in different platforms, how to interact the audience in different platforms in there. So like me, if I give an example, I'm not only in LinkedIn. I am being in a B2B marketing. I am in LinkedIn as well. I am in the Quora. I am in the other review platform who is talking about the softwares, who is talking about marketing softwares, how B2B handle. So today we will be talking about how we can use different channels and how to automate it. And so I will introduce today's speaker, Ankit Prakash, who is a co-founder of Eretic. He will be presenting us his PPT and knowledge. He will be sharing about how to use it. And this multi-channel success with marketing automation. So Ankit, I welcome you over here, and I'll stop sharing my screen. I'll give you the host panel and you can share. Yeah, Ankit, you're the host. Welcome, Ankit.
Hi, everyone. Hi. So thank you so much, Sonika, for hosting me for the third webinar. We have been having really good webinar sessions out here on marketing automation and then marketing related topics, where we focus most of the time on B2B and B2C targeting, where we can put across the marketing automation platform and how it can be used to target, retain, and then the value of the customer on different marketing automation platforms. So in this webinar, I'll be focused on having discussion on using the multi-channels, where we have many channels as of today. I hope many of you attendees would have heard about our webinar on different platforms like LinkedIn, LinkedIn events, WhatsApp, then on our website, on our blog, on our email newsletters. So you could see everyone is coming from different funnel. Everyone is coming from different funnel like email, then a WhatsApp group, then LinkedIn group, LinkedIn events, emails. So all these different places we are coming in this webinar and then joining in this webinar. But if we want to handle all these multi-channels, all these different channels of communication for any brand, for any product or for any service across, we have to be very much cautious and very much thoughtful when we want to, where we want to use all these channels. So if we could see when we are using all these channels for the benefit of the company, for the benefit of the product exposure, for the benefit of the service exposure, so we always think around how it can be used, how all of the messages can be crafted, what message can be crafted on one platform, what kind of message can't be crafted on other platforms. So over to this webinar, I will be having more detailed sessions. Let me share my screen so that I can show you my presentation and then take you through the presentation. After the presentation, we will be having Q&A session. So this first webinar session, it is going to be around 15 to 20 minutes. And then after that, the Q&A session where you can ask any of the question which is related to multi-channel, management of the multi-channel, getting more ROI on multi-channel, along different customer types, customer audiences. So any of the questions are welcome around multi-channel and how to implement these multi-channel with different marketing automation platforms. You are completely free to ask.
Yeah. Just to add one more point on that. Right now, I can't see the chat box where people can post their comment on the chat. So you can ask any question in Q&A. And if you are getting... Ankit, are you getting the chat option over there where people can comment?
Not as of now. It's not appearing out here, Sonika. I think there is some change on Zoom settings that has happened. Maybe, yeah. So it may be possible these webinars, they are just allowing Q&A sessions. So I could see there is one question from Surya Patra. Yes,
you
I can
see the chat option.
So a couple of our audiences are able to see. So this is where they have posted right now. I could see in Q&A. So cool. Let us go through the presentation and then we'll have the questions in Q&A.
Q&A session. Rather than in chat box, we can put in the Q&A.
Great.
Okay. Thank you.
Perfect. So I hope my presentation is viewable to everyone. So this is the very first presentation where we wanted to define what exactly is multi-channel automation. So on multi-channel automation, you could see we have when any of the marketing engagement or marketing communication engagement with the target contacts or the audience that happens through more than one channel. So there are many channels. If it is happening across different channels like email, SMS, push notification, then it is mostly the multi-channel automation, multi-channel engagement of the audiences. And most of the time, this multi-channel concept is used when your audiences or your customers are using more than one channel and then want to engage with you on different channels for different purpose, for different uses. Why is today multi-channel is essential. So if you could see, we have multi-channel automation is essential because there are more than one channel of communication which many of the customers are using or the contacts or audiences are using across the globe. For example, if today you are attending this webinar, you may have come through LinkedIn, or some of you may have come from WhatsApp, or some of you may have seen our message in our email campaign or on your LinkedIn profile also, and then would have joined and came back into this webinar session. So you could see you have used multiple of the channels where you could see our web happening of our webinar, and then you have joined this webinar session. So you could see why multi-channel automation is used. It is for three reasons. Very first reason is to connect with the customers. It gives you better ability as a brand. It gives you better ability to reach to your customer, listen to your customer, and then move ahead, keep them moving across the marketing and sales funnel very easily. Then the second essential reason is customers, they spend time on more than one channel. So it is always better to engage them at more than one places. For example, many of our customers are there on Instagram and on LinkedIn also. So for some regions, our marketing team, they also engage these kind of customers on Instagram and on LinkedIn also. So there is third reason which we are having, which is more and more channels that are getting into existence along the digital ecosystem. You could see a couple of years back, we do not have many of the channels, and all of a sudden in last 10 years or in last decade, a lot of explosion has happened in digital ecosystem where many of the channels came into existence. So you could see we have tried to put up all of the channels right back from 1980s, where we could see we had TV, we had radio, we had print, display and events, and then the fax as a channel of communication. Then in 1990s, you could see apart from TV, radio, print, we also got email, instant messengers, website, then search and online display ads. Moving forward to 2000s, you could see now the channels have started multiplying, where you could see we have mobile email, SMS, landing pages, microsites, blog, social networks. Then a mobile web is also there. Further down, today we have SMS plus MMS. Then we have rich text messages, voice marketing. Then social direct marketing is there on Twitter, on LinkedIn, on Facebook. Then we have group texting, then push notification, Twitter, TikTok, then geolocation based messaging, and then Vine, Periscope. So the list, if I'm going to talk, it is going to go keep and on, and a lot of users, they keep on hanging around many of these different channels. Although these channels are there, I'm not telling you to engage on every channel. So it completely depends on what kind of audiences you want to engage with yourself, for your brand, for your product or company. So you can identify these channels after you start investigating all of the customers through their customer persona. So when you build the customer persona, you could see the very two wide variety of the engagement of the channels that is happening across. So for example, if you are a B2C brand, so you could see consumers. So these, they usually single individual consumers, they hang out on SMS, rich text messages, push notification, mobile app notification, Facebook, WhatsApp, WeChat, or any of the chat applications. And they also hang around the city. They move around the city, and then they see ATL ads, ATL advertisements, above the line advertisements. Whereas in B2B, if you are going to see where the audiences usually hang around, their prominent channels of hanging around is email. The very first and prominent channel where they spend day in, day out is email. Then SMS, LinkedIn, blog and landing pages. Then assets like the B2B guys, they keep on reading a lot of assets like white papers, research papers, and very similar set of materials. And then they also hang around, they become a user of BTL advertisements, where below the line advertising targeted ads which come to them. So these are some of the mediums, the channels they hang around. Further, we have channel preference by target customers. For example, if you could see, if we today when we are in 2020 and going beyond, the more the older the channel is being used in very different ways. For example, email and SMS, many of the consumer behaviors, if you will see, everyone is using email and SMS for their backup purpose or for only for the transactional purpose. Or for example, if you are banking, if you are using your bank account attached with your email address, then you try to keep up all the transactions over there in email, or any of the purchases which you have done, all the invoices you want to keep up in email. And SMS mostly used use case as of today, where we could see everyone is using it as a one-time password, one-time notification reminder. So that is how SMS is being used. So all these channels, you could see, they are being used as a transactional channel or as engagement channel or as information channel. So you could see inside the engagement channel, we have all the social media coming in, where we have LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, then TikTok. All these places users or consumers are hanging around and doing the engagement with the content. And then we have WhatsApp, WeChat, phone call, then rich text messages, followed by that we have website pop-ups. All these are the engagement channels where all the audiences hang around to gather information, to gather to learn about something new, or to keep in touch with their friends, family, colleagues, and offices. Further to that, we have information channels, where we could see we have one-way channels like push notification, mobile app notification. So all these notifications, they come to the consumers, and today you could see everybody is getting all these push notifications from the web browsers, from the mobile apps, and then the mobile app notifications when we are using all these notifications. Further to this, we have some of the benefits which we have listed. If you as a business, you as a company who are engaging all of your customers along the multi-channel, then here are the benefits which you can drive in your marketing funnel. So some of the benefits out here which we have listed is 5 benefits. The first one is increase your campaign engagement. So if you are engaging your audiences, let us suppose if you are a B2C brand, and if you are engaging your audiences on multiple channels like SMS, post notification, you are engaging your audiences, then your top of the funnel, it increases a lot, where you could engage more and more audiences coming inside your marketing funnel. And when your top of the funnel is high, then there is better chances of conversion on large numbers down the funnel. The second benefit of implementing the multi-channel approach to your business is to enhance the customer's lifetime value and boost sales. Yes, when you are engaging them more than one channel, but here we need to be very much cautious. We should be engaging them on more than one channel. We should not be spoiling their experience with the push with pushing the messages, irrelevant messages to them that may spoil the experience. So when we are giving them very much relevant information on different channels, they welcome it, and then that is where the boost in sale happens, and lifetime of the consumer value also increases. The third benefit we have out here is to simplify selling by increasing the brand impression rate. So for example, if you are on multiple channels, it immediately increases your impressions. So for example, even during this time, during this lockdown time, when we are going through the pandemic and the whole world, so if you are in front of your customers on multiple channels, helping them out with one reason or other reason, then your brand retention increases and your brand value increases out there where the brand recall happens. Then the fourth benefit which we have listed out here is to generate custom intent-driven marketing campaigns. So when we are on multiple channels, we get to know the different intent of the customers. So for example, if we are on Twitter and then we are engaging them on Twitter, we know Twitter is Twitter composes messages around 200 characters. So it is more about short micro format stories where we engage with the target audience. So it gives us better opportunity to understand the customer's requirement and then generate the very highly intent messages to the customers on different channels. The last reason which we have listed out here is to analyze marketing strategies to identify the best performing channels. Yes, the multi-channel approach you should be applying out here for your business or your company is not only to engage, not only to retain, but also to keep on experimenting and keep on checking out the choices of different customers. For example, we have seen a lot of change in choices of the customer in last couple of years, where we have seen earlier B2B customers were not engaging on push notification, but in last 2 years, we could see they are engaging on email and on push notification also, but on push notification, they are only getting to know about the latest happenings or to get informed or to get in touch with the brand. So you could see the change in the uses of the channels can also be addressed using the multi-channel approach. To improve the ROI of whole of the marketing, whole of the multi-channel approach, we have listed 6 points out here, which is very much useful. If you are following some of these practices, it is going to improve the ROI of your overall multi-channel campaigns or multi-channel workflows for your brand. These are some you need to avoid marketing campaigns at initial stage. You should not use many of the multi-channel approach at initial stage. It is more like try and test if you are implementing for the first time or you are activating your customers on one new channel on your platform, on your business. So it is always a good practice to go ahead with simple marketing campaigns rather than sticking to or directly executing the complex campaigns where you might face difficulty to measure the marketing campaigns. So you should also do not stick to one single channel. So you need to keep on experimenting with many channels out here where your customers are hanging around, and you can think of if you are present, you can bring in some of the use cases in front of them. The third one is to follow and identify ideal prospects for reducing time and money wastage. So as we always say in marketing, we should always be closer to the customers and check upon what they are looking for. And if something aligned with the brand, if that can be produced or that can be reached out, so we should always keep on doing with the target audiences, and we should engage them. This immediately reduces the time and the money wastage or any kind of additional budget expense. It reduces them drastically. Then we have to be very much relevant to grab their attention. So for example, Twitter, if we are engaging the customers on Twitter, then on Twitter, one is the poll feature, which we have seen, it works really well, but it may be possible the poll feature doesn't work on LinkedIn. So this is one of very relevant example where we could see different platforms or different channels are getting the choices along. For example, on Twitter, if you are announcing a lot of polls, then you are going to get a lot of engagement. You might not get the poll engagement on SMS. So again, this is one more. You need to be very much relevant according to the channels. The fifth one is to build connection with new channels. So when you are building connections with new channels or activating a new channel on your business or brand, you should always build new connections. So for example, you should always welcome not only the existing customers but also welcome new customers. This means you should also invite the new audiences from top of the funnel and pull them, engage them, and then try to pull them down the funnel into the lead nurturing funnel. Then the sixth point which you can follow is to keep analyzing the campaigns to make better plans. So as we say, when we are running any kind of campaign, if it is multi-channel campaign, engaging the new channels out there, it is always good to keep on analyzing what is working or what is not working. Then we have to set up the right channel frequencies. Also, here are some of the frequencies we have seen that works really well if we are engaging them on certain of these channels. For example, on email, if we are sending them 5 to 6 maximum emails like newsletters, update, communication updates, then the prospects, leads, or any of the contact, they welcome it. If it is going beyond, then it may be possible they will opt out from the channel. The same thing we have observed on the push notification. If it is 3-4 times in a month, and if it is time sensitive information, then all the leads they are finding it really well out there. And even on SMS or WhatsApp or push notification, if you are a B2C brand, then notification 5 to 6 times, very much relevant notification, usually audiences in welcome from the brand. If you are going beyond all of these, then what happens is that your unsubscribe or your churn or your opt-out rate increases on these different channels. So setting up right frequency for your channels is very much important. Otherwise, your audiences, your contacts are going to get disturbed, or they are not going to be interested in engaging on any of these channels. Moving further, we have some of the core functionalities of the marketing channel, of the marketing, multi-channel marketing, which we can use. So here are three core functionalities which we have listed over here. The very first one is you have to use trigger-based automation workflows to communicate. For example, the trigger-based workflows, if a lead is coming back on the website on certain page, then they should get the same kind of email where they are searching something, where they are engaging or clicking something on the website. So these kind of workflows you can activate in your marketing automation platform, and your marketing automation platform can communicate them with relevant information which they have been visiting on your website. So it is always very engaging to put up trigger-based automation workflows that can help you engage them more and more. Then followed by that, the second one is to always target with the personalized customer's experience. So when you are putting up the trigger-based workflow, you should always make it personalized. For example, if somebody coming from a certain geolocation, then a relevant email, if it is going around that geolocation and their timings, it is they always welcome. The audiences, those who are coming on the website or any of the channels where you can find them out getting engaged, then you can engage them on these channels. So make the messages personalized. And then finally, you have to measure all of the success. As we could see, a successful marketing campaign or successful marketing always happens on test and measure and execute. So the same thing we have to do out here is to manage and measure the workflows. We need to keep on checking how the workflows are working. Is somebody, some contacts are hanging around, or they are not moving down the funnel, they are not how they are performing, or any new channels need to add over there where you can activate the customer's engagement. So all these three core functionalities of the multi-channel marketing are going to be used, and it is going to be very much useful. So looking at these challenges, you can see we have, if we start activating customers on many of the channels, yes, then we are going to face some of the challenges also. Like we have some of the difficulties, like difficult to maintain a consistent message across all channels. That is consistency of the messages, where your customers should not get confused. So this is one of very important point which you need to take care of while implementing or activating customers on different channels. You also need to understand the requirement on different channels. As I said earlier, so different customers, they have different requirement with respect to their different channels. So we need to be very much clear on understanding their channel requirements. For example, we cannot organize poll on SMS. Yes, there is workaround that can be done, but usually customers find it difficult, or anybody finds it difficult, to engage on certain engagements on certain channels. So that is going to be a challenge. Then we have to find the customer's voice. What is the average customer's voice on the channel? We always need to look up on. And then that is one of the, again, challenge which we face when we implement multi-channel approach to any of the engagement brand. Again, we have to maintain customers' consistent experience to avoid any kind of confusion. So for example, if you are implementing many multi-channel approach like SMS, email, and let us say if you are a B2C brand, on email you say that the inventory is available, and on SMS the customer is getting the inventory is not available. So it creates a lot of confusion among the customers. So you should always keep them into consistent messages. It should not be different on different platforms. So these are some of the challenges that you may face across the platform. So better approach is to getting ahead with multi-channel marketing automation with an integrated ecosystem. If it is integrated with your multiple ecosystem like ERP, like CBS, like CRM, then it delivers far better experience compared to any unconnected system. When we are implementing multi-channel, then what happens a lot of time, we always ask, or we run down the question like, what is multi-channel and what is omni-channel? So multi-channel is simply the use of different channels to engage with your audiences, engage with your customers. Whereas omni-channel is the right approach, which engages your audiences with consistent experience using multi-channel approach. So as I said earlier, during the challenges, like if the message is not consistent, then customers are going to get confused. So omni-channel addresses that challenge out here, and it gives the consistent experience across the whole multiple channels. So here are some of the success stories implementing multi-channel and omni-channel, like Friend and Farms, then Word, and then some of other famous companies like Apple, and then Walt Disney, Starbucks. So these are some of the successful companies who have implemented a lot of marketing automation campaigns on multi-channel and omni-channel approach. Here are the reference links which our team has put up on the slide. If you can go through these links, we'll be sharing this PPT with you. And when you are going through these links, you are going to find out what kind of multi-channel approach they have adopted in different regions for their customers to engage, reactivate, and engage with their audiences. You can find out. Then Aritech is definitely one of the choice for marketing automation. We have a product platform called Aritech Pinpoint, which you can use to get to implement the multi-channel platform. This is my profile, and over to the Q&A sessions. So I'm going back to Sonika. Yep.
Thank you for this PPT. Yes, sir.
I'm making you an host. So now you can ask on the questions Q&A session. So I could see a couple of questions and answers are there. So we can address them. I hope my PPT was clear, and you guys have got to learn a lot around multi-channel challenges and the success stories and how to implement them.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you for sharing such an informative PPT with us and giving knowledge. And so I can see some of the questions over here. So we are open for Q&A. Thank you again, Ankit, for your PPT. And I think so we can take Q&A, right, Ankit?
Yes.
Questions. So yeah. So you can put down questions over here in Q&A, as I am not getting the chat option right now. So you can put your question, anything you're having. So one of our audience asked that how to choose a multi-channel marketing for any business, for B2B or B2C. So yeah, so after starting a business, how to see what platform we can use, where we can see where our customers are hanging out, or where the customers are, and what are the engagement percentage of that? How can we can choose the platform for our business?
So when we are looking for engaging the audiences according to the business, where we are just starting up with the business, then it is always to find out the ideal customer profile or the customer persona who is going to purchase your product. So for example, if any case, if we see if there is a wall clock, we need to understand who is going to purchase the wall clock. Right. So if the wall clock is there, and if it is manufacturing a wall clock, then the manufacturer of the wall clock, then they are going to find out, they could see the customers and customers today, either they are purchasing online or they are going to the nearby retail store. So that is where they purchase, they engage with the wall clock. So now, for example, to purchase the wall clock, if they are going to nearby retail store, then the business, the wall clock manufacturer, they have to make relationship with the retail stores and then put up stock their wall clock at the retail store. And also they have to they could see today a lot of people are shopping online on Amazon or Flipkart or any of the online retail store where they are purchasing the wall clocks. Then they can get their products directly listed on the e-commerce channels, and from there they can start generating sales. And they can also engage, they can also build, if they are planning to build up their own brand, then they can start selling directly through the website channel also. But for that, they will have to engage in a lot of advertising mediums, a lot of ATL ads on online medium, or any ATL ads on offline medium, from where they can start acquiring the traction on their website. And then from there, they can start engaging and then engaging around their products. So you could see in this example, when we are implementing different multiple channels for this particular business, then it is going to be very much useful when they are engaging on multiple of places, multiple of the channels.
Yeah, thank you. Ankit, I guess you forgot to put on your video after the PPT. So your camera is off.
Yeah. So I think there's some message. Because the host has stopped it, I cannot switch on the video. Okay, cool. Let me switch it on. Perfect.
Yeah. So next question we have is, what do you recommend for closing a B2B sales cycle? What is the some best practices for closing it in multi-channel platforms? If it's a B2B.
If it is a B2B. So most of the time, B2B audiences, as we could see, they usually hang around on email, they hang around on LinkedIn, and some of the audience types, they are also hanging around on Twitter. So if they are hanging around on any of these platforms, then you can build strategies to keep on engaging these B2B audiences on these platforms. So this is usually what we have seen, these audiences hang around. If even in some cases, if you are if you are a small product company, or if your ticket size is small, a lot of B2B audiences also hang around on Instagram. So you can engage your target audiences on Instagram also. Instagram you have ad, and Instagram you can also engage with the audiences like lead based ads, which connects with most of the marketing automation platforms, where you can send them relevant information about your products, and then you can engage with these audiences directly from Instagram. So when you are engaging with these audiences from different of the places you could see in B2B. Also, you get many opportunities to engage from multiple places. So only thing is that out there, you need to keep on experimenting, finding out where the relevant conversation is going on, where the relevant target audiences are hanging around. And then based on that, all these engagement should be created.
Okay, thank you. Next question is, what is the best solution for set up an enterprise system to manage customer profile and integrate with multi-channel marketing providers?
So most of the time, I could see you should go ahead with the solutions like where you have built-in CDP that can manage whole of your audience profiles, contact management, then contact management having all the features like contact property management, then contact tracking, and then contact tracking across multiple channels like website, blog, landing pages, ads, email, SMS. If you can implement any of the automation platform which has built-in CDP, then they are very much useful for you to get started with all these platforms. So these kind of platforms, when you have CDP, then you can keep them engaged out there on multiple places.
Yeah. Hope you got an answer. Q&A, one of the person is asking for this question. Hope he got an answer. Most of the people are asking about our Aritech software. So you can contact us on support system, and we are happy to reply on that email if you want to know more about Aritech software. And we are looking for the question more of conceptual base or how to use it, strategies and related to that. So yeah, we are open for that kind of questions. So yeah, I have one question. I have prepared some questions for myself to clear my doubts. So is there any marketing channel software or for offline events also to track or these platforms also, like offline, if I'm conducting as a marketer, if I'm conducting any offline event, how to track that audience, how to do multi-channel marketing over there on them, mm-hmm. how to engage them?
So depending on your tech stack, there are many solutions to track offline engagements. Also, if you can look up on the marketing automation platforms like Aritech, or there are many platforms which integrates with systems like DMP, with systems like offline tracking applications like Rapleaf. So there are many application providers who provide offline to online engagement kind of tracking. If your marketing automation platform is integrated with all these applications, then you can definitely keep on tracking their behavior on offline and even on online. For example, in this very much very relevant example is there are people, those who are engaging on newspapers, and they are engaging on TV channels from the same publication of the company or same TV news channels. Then they can track who all are reading their newspapers also, and who all are reading their news or viewing their news on the TV channels. So all these things today are possible using many different combination of technologies where you can find out and then start engaging them in different mediums. For example, if somebody has stopped reading the newspaper from the same brand, you can engage them into online medium, and then you can present with the online digital newspaper or digital magazine to them, where you can engage them in live in online medium. So you could see there are many solutions available across the ecosystem which can be used in combination to provide complete experience for whole of audience management across multi-channel.
So talking about email marketing, after having a lead generation campaign in a Facebook or some other campaigns, so after getting the leads, after doing email campaigns, talking about big data and marketing automations, so how we can use it for the email marketing for this cross channel and this use?
So as I said, the channels, you need to be very much specific where for what purpose you are using any channel. If you are using email marketing for top of the funnel, then all of your email marketing is completely different in top of the funnel, coming to mid of the funnel and bottom of the funnel. All of the email marketing engagement is completely different, where you have more serious talks with your contact or the leads. So when we are implementing any of these approach on email marketing or any of the data, if we have a lot of information available, then as soon as the leads going down the funnel, more and more personalization starts coming into email marketing, email campaigns which they are receiving. So for example, if at top of the funnel, if there are contacts, then at top of the funnel, very basic emails can work, but as soon as they move across and they move down the funnel, more relevant, more specific emails, the leads or the contacts, they're always welcome. Otherwise, they go away or move away from the email, reading the emails.
So more focus on the personalization and how you can interact with them, what kind of content you are giving to them, as depend upon the funnel you are having.
Yes. So looking upon the requirements, looking upon their what stage they are there, what stage in the marketing funnel they are there, then based on those, these kind of marketing, these kind of email campaigns should contain those information.
Okay. Thank you, Ankit. We are looking for more questions. If you have any other questions, ask us and we are happy to answer that. So most of the things we have answered is mainly the questions we are getting is the difference of B2B and B2C, how to do different strategies we should implement, what are the different strategies we should implement in B2B and B2C, what will be the different, how the difference of interaction will be there, and these all questions I think so you want to answer in this question.
Yeah, so as I have, even during the presentation, I have answered a lot of differences in B2B and B2C, how they can be used. And I think our team has also written a lot of really good blog posts that is available on Heretic, where you can read out all these blog posts and find out how these different use cases can be implemented across your brand engagement with your customers for anyone, if it is B2B or if it is B2C, you can engage with them.
Yeah. So we have posted a link here in the Q&A, as chat box is not available for us. So we have posted a LinkedIn link of that, our YouTube channel. And so you can reach out if any question about multi-channel marketing is there, you can reach out to Ankit Prakash. In his profile as well, you can go and have a conversation with him as well. So so anything else, sir?
Yep. So I think we are almost done, right? So we are out here in India. We have 750, and Sonika, so you can continue with the company's introduction.
We have a little. I have a little information to share with you guys. So this is the speaker, Ankit, which he shared some good insight of the knowledge of multi-channel marketing. And he is the co-founder of Heretic. And just a minute, there's some hang. Yeah. So Heretic is a SaaS platform. Of a business operation of Data ID, so he's a part of the Data ID software. The company is having two products, MD and Heretic. Heretic is more for mid enterprise, and enterprise will take care of Heretic is a platform where you can use marketing automation and other platforms also, other users also, and Heretic is being used by 2,000 plus companies, and from January 2020. We have started in India and Southeast Asia market also. Couple of brand which Heretic platform they are using, like Kotak, Personal Marketing, Media Prime, and Reliance Booking Groups, etc. So in this ecosystem, we have some other products like Pinpin, Sales CRM, Dex, Mail, Form, Press, and Socials. These are the other platforms which you can go around and see, which we use for business as well. So you can see. And we have launched EasySend, Pinpoint, Sales CRM, Dex, Mail, and Form. And you can see the features in our website. And in May 2020, we will be launching Analytic Press, Analytic Social, and Analytic Meet. And soon we will be launching Analytics. So this webinar series we have launched by Analytic Live, and name of Analytic Live. This is an online talk show which primarily focus on the webinar marketing topics, interaction of people regarding this all marketing related topics, podcast, webcast, and connecting with other people and talking about that. So so we are located in Bangalore. We have our office over there. You can come down and reach to us if you want to. And so this is our profile, and you can talk to us and reach to us. So thank you for coming, and thank you for joining in this webinar. Thank you, Ankit, for sharing your insight with us. Thank you for sharing the PPT. It was amazing to have you over here. And this 1 hour long session, it was very useful for me, and I hope it was useful for the other attendees as well. Hope they got a knowledgeable session over here. And see you soon again. And thank you for coming. Thank you, Ankit, for coming here and sharing the knowledge.
Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all.